We'll start by honoring Engineering Project of the Year. This category recognizes excellence in surmounting specific engineering challenges, whether in complex environments, in executing a precision task, or in solving specific problems in creative ways. The finalists are SOVCOMFLOT, Royal Dutch Shell, and Samsung Engineering. Chris, please tell us about our winner.
Thanks, Andy. It's been great to see companies are still willing to take on such challenging engineering projects. Despite a smaller group here, this was certainly a passionately contested category. The ultimate winner designed a two-in-one marvel. I wonder what that could be, Andy. This winning project combines conventional LNG carrier with an icebreaker.
Well, I guess that rules out any prelude.
I heard a shout for Shell there, but I think you might be right. This vessel's steel-reinforced structure enables it to sail independently through ice 2 meters thick, opening up new opportunities in the Arctic Circle, icebound for up to 9 months of the year. Along with traditional fuels, this revolutionary vessel can run LNG boil-off, enabling a significant reduction in harmful emissions critical in the fragile Arctic environment. In August, the Christophe de Margerie, named after the former head of Total who tragically died in an accident in Moscow, became the world's first merchant vessel to travel the full length of the Northern Sea Route without an icebreaker escort. Judges appreciated this winner's strategic play to open up LNG delivery to Asia, a move with financial upside for our winner's home country. So the winner from Russia for the Engineering Project of the Year is SOVCOMFLOT. Congratulations.
We got a ticket that takes us wherever we like. We got our problems, but just for the minute, let's push all our troubles aside. Alright, cause we got the keys to the universe inside our minds. Yeah, we got the keys, baby.
Thank you all, and as you've gone as far as getting Russian on stage, I wouldn't miss this opportunity to say a couple of words. First, my thanks go to the judges, and to go on record, I haven't met or made any contact or otherwise tried to influence their decision. So thank you for this independent decision, but more importantly, more seriously, thank you for your fairness, for your open-mindedness, for your objectivity, and for your friendship. I think this is very much the qualities that reflect the spirit of the energy industry, where the stakes are high, where the cost of mistakes are extremely high, and where the decisions are long-term, the project cycles are exceptionally long-term, and the projects themselves require multi-billion dollar decisions. Our project is about an innovative ice-breaking LNG carrier that will allow safe and reliable transportation to energy around the world. And we are very proud to be serving the industry and to be receiving this award today. Last time I was standing on the stage 10 years ago when we got the first award from Platts, that was in the Energy Transporter of the Year category. At the time, we were competing with pipeline companies, power grid companies, and to date, we remain the only shipping company to have ever received that award. Well, that's partly to do with the fact that Platts discontinued the award category. but again, I think on a more serious note, I think we took that award as recognition of the role that shipping plays in servicing global economy, global energy, and global trade as a provider of maritime transportation of energy around the world. And today's award, the Engineering Project Award, is hopefully recognition of the evolution that SOVCOMFLOT has made in these 10 years from a pure transportation company to a more diversified marine energy services company capable of undertaking these complicated projects and adding value to our energy clients. Thank you all.
Should we run to?